Is the Apple M1 chip still king in 2023? Yeah. I can already hear you saying, but Jesse, the M2 was just released. Why should we care about the M1? Well, I'm gonna tell you why. Even with the shiny new M2 in the wild, the M1 is the best upgrade for every single person. Did you know that Apple has been making their own silicon for over a decade? It's at the heart of the iPhone, iPad, and Apple Watch. With the release of their debut computer silicon, the M1 in 2020, they promised dramatic improvements for performance and power efficiency over their Intel generation Macs. What makes the M1 truly special is its system on a chip, SoC, design, which combines a microprocessor, memory, input-output interfaces, and other components into one powerful package. This means that the SoC can get things done quickly and smoothly without wasting time or energy on unnecessary tasks. Now let's talk about specs. The M1 has 4 high-performance cores for multi-threaded workloads and 4 high-efficiency cores for lightweight tasks. It also has a 16-core neural engine that is capable of executing 11 trillion operations per second, and an 8-core GPU that delivers blazing fast integrated graphics. When Apple released the M1 chip, they made a bold claim that it had up to 2 times more CPU and graphics performance than any other PC laptop. While some skeptics thought these claims were overhyped, the truth is that the M1's mind-blowing improvements over its predecessor Intel chips speak for themselves. In fact, the M1 single-core performance outperforms not only the Intel Core i9, but also the Mac Pro Xeon, which was generally considered a high-performing chip. In benchmark tests, the M1 scored an impressive 54% higher than its closest competitor, the 16-inch MacBook Pro. These results are a testament to Apple's innovation and dedication to providing its users with the best possible performance. Along with those impressive performance improvements, the Apple Silicon's upgraded efficiency cores allowed up to 17 hours of web browsing or up to 20 hours of video playback on battery. Imagine being able to take an international flight from Sydney to LA with a single charge, watch some flicks, and still have some juice left over. Insane. After 2 years, the M1 chip is no longer the new kid on the block, but it's still the reigning champion. The M1's optimization and compatibility with the latest software updates, such as macOS Ventura, make it a powerhouse that's hard to beat. You may be wondering why you should upgrade to the M1 instead of the M2. And the truth is, most people upgrade their devices around every 5 years. And with many still using pre-2020 Intel models, an upgrade is due. The M2 may sound exciting, but the M1 was a groundbreaking shift that revolutionized Apple's technology. The M2, on the other hand, is an incremental improvement, like the upgrade from one iPhone generation to the next. By upgrading to the M1, you'll get a huge performance boost that will last you for years to come. So what should you get? Well, the longevity of the 2020 MacBook Air speaks volumes about the impressive capabilities of the M1 chip. It's not often that a laptop from 2 years ago remains the best option on the market, but for $920 US, the MacBook Air continues to impress. Easily the very best and highest recommended laptop for the everyday user. And even if you dabble in photo editing or light coding, this laptop can handle it. Now, if you're looking for something with more power for creative work, like video editing or 3D rendering, then the 2021 MacBook Pro M1 Pro is the perfect choice. While the M2 MacBook Pro may be tempting, trust me, you will be blown away with the M1 Pro. these laptops are still available for sale for about $1,600 US. I'll be sharing my full 1 year later MacBook Pro M1 Pro video real soon. So make sure to subscribe to check it out when it drops. Thanks for watching, guys. And remember, stay hyped.